close-up look at animal welfare issues with your host, writer, speaker, and advocate, Tina Evangelista-Eppenstein. This show is supported in part by AnimalWelfareIssues.com, spotlighting issues around the globe. Check out the latest TV shows, articles, podcasts, and more. That's AnimalWelfareIssues.com. Now here's your host, Tina, in 3, 2, 1.
Good evening, I'm Tina Evangelista-Eppenstein, and thanks for joining us this evening. If you've noticed here in the Northeast, we've been enduring a heat wave, but the Northeast isn't the only part of the nation that's enduring the hot temperatures. Down North Carolina, they have heat advisories, Virginia, Nevada, so I think it's a large chunk of the nation that's enduring hotter temperatures, and with a heat wave we're enduring 90 degree weather. So with that 90 degree weather, we want to make sure that we check on the elderly, the sick. We want to make sure our children are safe, and of course we want to make sure that our pets are safe during this hot weather. We're hearing a lot of reports, at least I am, a lot of reports of dogs that are dying in cars, animals that are being left outside in this horrendous heat. And joining me tonight to talk about this dangerous heat and how we can protect our pets is Janine Choplick, our great, great humane officer from Hillside SPCA. And I want to welcome Janine for joining me this evening. Thank you. If you could bring up a picture of the puppy, a police officer is holding a puppy. If you could bring that up. Janine, tell us about this little puppy. Let's get right into it.
We got a call about a very young puppy being stuck in a crate in the middle of a backyard. The caller said it had been that way since 6 o'clock in the morning. We got there about 2:30, and we did get the puppy out of that situation, thankfully, in the nick of time.
And he was in a crate. If you could show the picture of the crate, there you go. And he's in there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So this is how he was in the middle of a yard with, no water, nothing. No water, no food, no blanket, nothing. And he was there from, 6 to 2:30?
Mm-hmm.
And who called you?
I believe it was a neighbor who heard the puppy literally screaming, because when I talked to her on the phone, I could hear the puppy screaming in the background. I was really hoping we would get there in time, and thankfully we did. He was very thirsty. He didn't suffer a whole lot of ill consequences, which we're very thankful for, but I'm so thankful the neighbor did call, and she was a distance away. So I'm just thankful she heard it, and she did make that phone call. She saved his life.
The owner wasn't home?
No one was at the door. No one would answer the door. There was no one home.
So they were away, and they left their puppy just right outside.
Yes.
Is it one person or is it a family?
I really don't know. I believe it was one person. I believe it was just one person. I don't know why. I really don't know why. I'm just thankful. That was not even an eight-week-old puppy. Young dogs do have a difficult time with the heat also, and
right.
I'm just very thankful that he made it through that.
Yeah, and you said he was adopted. The puppy was turned over to Hillside.
Yes.
And so the puppy now has a better home.
Wonderful home, yes.
Being well taken care of. There was another case in Delaware County. If you could show the picture of the emaciated pit bull. In Delaware County, there was a case of two dogs that were left outside. Two dogs left inside along with, I forgot what, there was fish, I don't know if it was a lizard, but this dog right here, well, the one dog, when they got the call, the humane officer went there, and an Akita mix was tied up outside with no shelter whatsoever. And when the officer got there, that dog was in the middle of having seizures, and the dog actually passed away in front of the officer. An officer tried to resuscitate the dog, didn't have any luck. And this is the other dog that was kept outside in a wire crate and with something on top. I don't know if it was cardboard or a blanket, but they feel that saved the dog's life because to protect him from the sun, but still no water, no food, and dogs left inside. They found some small bowls of water. But this woman was on vacation and she just left her animals outside to fend for them. So I don't have logic behind that. I mean, do you find the three other dogs are going to make it? Well, okay, let's go right on. Okay, we're showing a boxer mix. And this is another dog that you helped. Tell us about this boxer.
Well, this is a young dog, about a year old, and he has been tied out. The people admitted he's tied out every day from morning until night. He does, they said, go in at night. He has absolutely no shelter at all. As you can see in the picture, there is nowhere for him to get out of the elements. He did have a very small bowl of water, and I can't imagine how hot the water must have been if there was water in it. So it's basically almost undrinkable.
Could he reach it? Because it's all the way over on the right of the screen. And I can't tell how long, whatever he's on, if it's a rope or if it's chain, but could he reach it?
I really don't know. I was quite upset when I saw that, and he was relinquished to our shelter also, thankfully, because the heat on both days was 92 degrees in the shade, and I don't think either one of those dogs would have lasted through this heat wave in being treated like that.
So who notified Hillside? A neighbor?
That was another neighbor, yes. That was another neighbor.
So, I mean, we have to be the voices.
Absolutely.
I mean, for these animals, if we see an animal in distress, we have a home viewer. We'll get right back to if we see an animal in distress, or we're going to take the home viewer. Go ahead, home viewer.
Yeah, I'd like to know, is it legal to break a window to get a dog out of a car, or will I get arrested for it if the dog is ready to die, if he, like, is already almost passed out? And will I get arrested for it, or will I be not legally held responsible? I'll hang up so I can hear your answer. Thank you very much for your show. It's a very good show, and it really helps to educate people.
Thank you very much. Okay, I believe he was asking if it's okay to break into a car to save an animal in distress. Now, in Pennsylvania, there are 16 states that forbid people to leave pets unattended with the hot or the cold. So Pennsylvania does not currently have a law. So
I have done some research on this. Also, there is several steps you could take. A good place to find out, this is an evaluate and document the situation is the first step here. If you go to preventivevet.com, it will list everything that you need to do. One of the most important things to do, I think, is document everything. You want to document, you want to have witnesses, because I'd say the chances are pretty good that whoever left their animal in the car may not be happy that their window is broken. So you may end up going to court, but you may be able to protect yourself if it's a matter of life or death, and they do decide to take you to court. The court could very well and likely would be on your side, but you also have to stop and think that after you break the window and the dog is in dire need of any kind of care, that dog must also be taken to a vet, so you complete the whole scenario. But if you go to preventivevet.com, it will actually tell you exactly how to, if you see distress signals, explains what the signals are, if the pet is currently comfortable. I actually printed it out for myself because I thought this is absolutely perfect. You also want to make sure that you do contact the location, if it's a store, contact the people inside the store and make sure that the word is out that the animal's in there. Post it on Facebook. That's the last thing anybody wants to know is that their animal or their car has been posted on Facebook, that they haven't been taking care of their animal. And if anybody knows those people in this car that you post, maybe they would contact them and get the word out there.
Well, I think I was reading, you can also videotape to show that this animal is in fact in distress. Yes. To, like you say, if you go to court, you know, if this owner is unhappy, to show that this animal Absolutely. Really needed help. And as you said, you know, get the animal to the vet right away. And, you know, I have to admit that I couldn't see how anybody could leave their pet behind in a car. I mean, for me, I couldn't do it. And then I was reading this article, and this woman put out a plea. Her dog, she left her dog in the car, and she is looking for help. She's so distraught, and she doesn't know how to live with herself. So she's asking people for help, how to get through this, because she doesn't think she can get through this. She said it was her best friend. How could she ever do this to her best friend? And all these responses that I was reading gave me another perspective of this, that has happened to a number of other people. And some were saying they don't know how they can go on much longer with their lives. They were saying the same thing about, you know, how could they do this, their best friend, their family member. I mean, I guess it can happen. People have children, they become preoccupied, or the dog sneaks in, you just don't know, they're being quiet. But I think the same as children who have been left inside cars, we have to be aware, we must always check. And someone made a suggestion one time, you know, like tie something to your steering wheel to make you remember something, you know, and it's like to look for your pet, you know, yes. before you go in. It is preventable, and it does happen. I did get a different perspective by reading this, but I personally could never do it. I mean, that's me. I mean, well, my pets are just always with me, you know, in the passenger side, so.
You can't miss them.
So it's really hard. And I have to say, if I did see a pet in distress, we talked about this before, when the Fab Four were on here, we all agreed we would do it. If the animal's in distress and is going to, you know, minutes away from dying, I think you're going to do what you have yes. to do. But other recourse you can take is, first of all, like Janine said, take down the information, post it, but also if they're right in a business area, in stores, go to the stores, ask them to make an announcement, let them know that their pet may be in distress or is panting quite heavily. You can do that. Or call your local shelter, police. Do you want to call the emergency number 911, or do you want to call the non-emergency number?
I guess it depends what the situation is. Probably the non-emergency number would be just as good as the 911. I'm not sure how the police would.
I guess every place is different.
I guess, yes, I guess it depends on the police department. I know we have some really wonderful police departments that we work with, and I don't think they would ever mind getting that phone call to help out. I'm sure they would step right up.
I'm seeing more stories where the officers are, yes. are I guess, I forgot what state it was, but I saw this video where the cop, he used a cutter and smashed in and got the dog out. I mean, this dog was minutes away from dying, and the window was smashed, but this dog climbed over the broken window. I mean, he wanted to get out. He couldn't breathe any longer, and I didn't know if he was going to make it. He was on the sidewalk, and he just wasn't moving, and then slowly came around, and then slowly he drank, and he was going to be okay, but that's how close it was for that animal. So police officers do a great job, as do our humane officers. I want to talk about, you know, the symptoms to look for, you know, with this heat. If your dog's outside in a car, and luckily you keep your dog at home, that is the best advice I think I can give, or Janine can give. But what should we look for to know our pet or an animal is in distress from the heat?
Well, I think one of the first signs is a lot of panting, and then they start getting a little frantic, and they'll start pawing at maybe windows inside the car, and then it progresses from there. You'll see they may start vomiting. Their gums, we probably can't see that right away, but their gums will become discolored. They may...
Is it because oxygen isn't getting there, or...?
It's just because the blood is
okay.
Yeah, it's just actually, if you don't get a dog to a vet after it's been in that kind of heat, the dog will probably die because it's brain swelling. One thing you never want to do is if you do get a dog out of a situation, don't pack it in ice because they said that the blood vessels do not... They will dilate then, and it doesn't allow the blood to circulate normally. So cool.
That's why. Cool. I read cool water. Cool towels, but not cold.
Not cold.
Or ice.
Yes. But definitely a veterinarian, because there's a lot of treatment that has to go into it. Just, it messes up the whole, any animal that's out in the heat messes up their whole system. It's very serious.
I read they can get a red tongue or a purple tongue, I believe.
Yes.
And then the excessive drooling is a means of sweating for them, because they only sweat through the pads and then their nose. And so when the excessive drooling is their way of getting rid of that heat within their body. And in a car, even in 60 degree weather, a car can heat up if left out in the sun. And I don't know if people understand that. And keeping that windows cracked open just a little bit,
work.
That's not doing anything. Nope. My husband and I actually saw a dog a number of days ago, actually one of the hottest days, in the car. The windows were rolled down pretty much, and found the person that this dog belonged to in the store. And I said something to the woman, and she said, yeah, I better get out there. And I was talking to her, and my husband went outside, and he was making sure the dog was okay. And the dog was okay, and then she went out. But, I mean, I was very nice of her, cordial about it. But, I mean, if we can, save a life.
Yes.
And then the other day, my husband was stopped. A man said, he stopped him, I need help. And he was taking his dog for a walk. And that's another thing, any kind of excessive exercising right now, mm-hmm. I think you should really do it in the early morning, late evening.
Right.
Well, this was, I guess, later in the morning or early afternoon, I'm not sure, and the dog was collapsed. And he said, please, can you take me home? My dog can't walk. And my husband took the guy with the dog, he took him home. But we don't know how that dog fared. This dog just couldn't walk. And hopefully my husband, he knew I was doing the show, so he gave him all the information of what he can do to put some towels or cool him down, to get that body temperature down.
Yes.
So, and, get to a vet, as soon as possible.
Yes.
But this dog just could not walk any further. He said he won't move. He said he can't get up. So if the dog, any kind of excessive exercise, and dogs with short snouts, I mean, there are certain breeds like pugs and that, and bulldogs, they do not fare well in this heat. So you want to, we have to really beware.
Yes.
I mean, if you have to give one suggestion to somebody about pets and the heat, what would that be? More than one, go ahead.
My suggestion is when it gets warm, when it gets to 75 degrees, leave your pets at home.
Say that again?
Leave your pets at home. If it's going to be 75 degrees out and you know they will be spending time in the car, just don't do it. You don't want to leave your pets in the car ever. Unless your pet is going with you. If it's 75 degrees out, take them for a ride. You come back with them. You don't go shopping in a store. You don't go get an ice cream. You don't do anything. Let your pets at home.
Yeah, I know. I know some people leave their car running with the air conditioning on, and they have another set of keys. Their car is locked, but you don't know if something can happen to the AC. And, your dog can get stolen.
Sure.
As well, or a cat, whatever animal that you have can get stolen in the process. And I want to say for people who take their pets swimming during this heat, that not all dogs have the ability to swim. And I thought all dogs have that natural instinct to swim, but some can't, like dachshunds and is it bulldogs? I mean, with their weight and the shorter legs, they just can't swim. But I do want to say that if you're going to take your pet out on a boat, canoe, get a life vest for your dog, and this way your dog will be safe, your dog won't drown. This is for my dog Brody, and he's probably thinking, why am I not wearing this right now? But this will keep your pet safe if you go boating, and anything would happen if the boat would overturn, so you want to keep your pet safe at all times, no matter what you're doing. And this is actually from Roughwear, really good brand, so you can go to their website. Let's see. Is Hillside getting a lot of phone calls right now regarding pets and the heat?
Yes, lots, lots of calls. Some of it is just concern. Thankfully, out of the concerned ones, they're not very, very serious. We did have another one today, though. There was a dog tied outside without shelter. And I talked to the owner, and she did bring the dog in. I explained to her that is just not, she can't do that. And I said how hot it is. And it was a black dog, which is another thing we have to remember. The thick-coated black dogs will absorb the heat so much faster.
Definitely.
And she did bring him in. And I explained to her, I don't know if people just don't think about those things. I'm not sure. But she seemed to understand the severity of the situation, and she complied.
Do you think educating the people goes a long way? I mean, are they just oblivious to it?
I think they just don't give it a whole lot of thought. And when someone approaches them and explains that people have actually reported to us that there are other people watching, and they will make that call, and we did show up, I think they give it a second thought and say, gee, maybe that wasn't such a good idea.
Do you find in the state of Pennsylvania that we keep people tie up their animals outside more often than some other areas, or are we on the average to be the same as others?
You know, I don't know. I don't see as much now as I have years ago, but we still see it. And I think the scariest part of that is many times there are areas that we don't see, that it may be a very secluded area. So I'm not really sure. A lot of it is kind of on maybe a back road somewhere, or maybe there's not a whole lot of neighbors. And
yeah, unless you get that phone call, you're not.
Unless we get the phone call, yes.
And a doghouse is not good for a dog in heat. That's just going to keep the heat in, even though it's providing shelter. That just makes the dog hotter.
Yes.
I mean, so if you have a dog outside, that dog is suffering. If you're outside with a fur coat on, think about your pet that's outside. That pet is suffering. And if at all possible, please bring that dog inside. And also, if you see an animal in distress, please call your local shelter, call your local police to get help. And I see we're out of time, but we have about a minute or so, and I want to just talk about quickly about an event. This is an event that's being held for Hillside. It's called Roller Roost Skate Night, August the 7th,
yes.
6 to 9 p.m., and all proceeds go to Hillside. And this is a good deal, $3 at the door, and includes the skate rental fee. I don't think you can beat that,
yes.
And it's going for a good cause. So that's 6 to 9, and if you want to find out more, I guess they can go to your website.
Yes.
HillsideSPCA.com, and they can also go to your Facebook page. And on that same day, this is August 7th, that's 6 to 9 p.m., early in the day, Helping Hands Wildlife Center is having a fundraiser. They're having a bake sale, yard sale, Chinese auction, and they're having a pet skunk there, Ginger, will be on hand to greet the people. And that's also in Pottsville. So people can go to the Helping Hands Wildlife Center fundraiser first and then swing on over later for this event at the Roller Roost Skate Night for Hillside SPCA. If you see a pet in distress, please be their voice, because their voice, your voice, could mean the difference between life and death. Thank you, Janine, for joining me this evening. Always a pleasure. Thank you, and stay cool. Good night.